why it is named as a transposition cipher. Reason is that the position of the alphabets in the string or in the text are going to be changed. Okay, it is kind of scrambling. Okay, so if you are using only transposition to generate a cipher, that means you are only scrambling the position of four letters in the text. That means how many letters or whatever letters you had in the text, it will be as it is, only their position will be changed. Okay, so transposition, okay, this is also known as permutation cipher. So you understand what does permutation is. So it hide the message contains by rearranging the order of letters. Okay, the Skytel cipher is one of the example, and early Greek transposition cipher is the Skytel. And a script, what happened in that, a script of paper was wound around stuff. It can be a pencil, it can be anything, okay, wooden rod or anything, okay, and message written along the stuff in rows, then paper removed and leave a strip of seemingly random letter. I will show you the image how it happens of the paper. So how it was happening, it is something look like this. You can see it is hexagonal. No, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So it is octagonal, octagonal, right? One octagonal bar is there on which a paper is rolled in a kind of a spiral way. Okay, and you can see the message is written in row wise. Okay, now if you just take the paper out and if you see what is written on it, you will read that type like this: MAT and ADT. The things will come vertically and you will have scrambled letters of your message. But problem here is that as it is 8-sided bar, so your maximum distance one letter can shift can be 8. Right, so this is one limitation of this. So you can't expect, if you have 100 letters in the text, that first letter is going to be the 90th place. It is not going to go up to the travel up to that distance. Okay, so always if somebody is good in reading scrambled words, so people will easily can read it out. Okay, so by the way, this is a very, very old one, so it can be like this. The next comes Rel-fence cipher. So all of you have seen the Rel-fence, right? So what is it says that you write the text, or Rel-fence like lines, where say if you have plain text like defend the east wall, so you write like this defend, so in zigzag way, okay, and you just read them in this line by line, okay, and finally what you will get when you will read it line by line, that will be treated as cipher text. So cipher, when cipher, it is giving you cipher d f n t e a t a l and then e, so on. Okay, so here what is the key is you are getting key is one, because only your letters, one letters you are just moving away, right, from the ones you are skipping one letter, so which are going to be change their position. Okay, and if you just you can understand, if you find a middle point and rearrange them easily, you can find what was the plain text. So this can be bit complex, but it is not possible to make a very much complex, like instead of two lines you can have 8 lines, and you can diagonally write to downwards, and again diagonally you go to upwards, and so on you can do. Okay, so in that way you can just increase the key up to a very short variables, like 8, 20 maximum, how much you can do, you can understand, right? So this is why this scrambling technique also was not treated as a good one. Next, you can, the same thing you can see here. Instead of two fences or two lines, here we have three lines, and same text is written, you know, diagonally up and down zigzag way. And when it is reading the cipher, it is reading line by line. So D N E T L, you can see here D N E T L in the cipher, then L E E D, okay, L E E D, and so on. It is writing like this. So this is a, you know, bit complex than the previous one, and Kisha is here is 3. So what are the limitations? So limited number of usable keys, especially for the short messages, right? So if you have only these mass messages, you can't go for, you know, a key size of 8 or, you know, say 20, then it will, if you have 20, then what will happen? It will only remain the same text. It will actually not work at all. Okay. Then for there to be enough movement of letters, the length of the message need to be at least twice the key, but preferably 3 times the key. So due to this, it is saying that the length of the message, this length should be at least 3 times of the key length. Okay, so that, you know, it can have enough scrambling. Okay, so the use of null can also have a determinal effect on the security of the cipher, as an interceptor can use them to identify where the end of the line is, and so have a sensible guess at the key. So it is saying that if you keep the nulls as well in the cipher, so you know, the attacker can find out the nulls and find try to can able to track that what is your end of the line, and based on that they can, you know, they can have one step ahead at the time of analysis. Okay, and another thing is definitely the frequency analysis will crack it, because we are not changing the letter. Letters are there, only text is scrambled, so frequency analysis will easily work on it. Okay. Then geometric figure or rote cipher. So what is this? You write your whatever plain text is there in a line by line pattern, then you read it in a geometric fashion. So like, you know, this is a horizontal line by line fashion, you can read like this, you can read it like a vertical fashion, okay, or any other zigzag fashion you can create, any, you know, geometrical fashion you can create, and you can read, so that after, you know, reading it, the character you have read, they will become as scrambled letters of the text. Okay, so there are other thing like row transposition cipher, like the text you have, you just write them in again row and column way, okay, and then you just scramble the rows and read them through columns. So we will have, you know, we will have scrambled the letter. So that can be one way to do it. Okay, so these are a few transposition techniques we have seen, and you have to understand the transposition, only transposition is very weak to make a cipher or to encrypt something. So what we actually need is combination of transposition and substitution. So all other cipher we will find later on are